Good morning, class. As you all know that in the previous chapter we had covered the five stanzas of the poem Casablanca. Now in this class there were five more stanzas we are going to cover, and then the poem ends there. Okay, so let us start. Upon his brow he felt their breath and his waving hair, and looked from that lone post of death in still yet brave despair. So the children, these lines say that upon his brow he felt their breath. Now that the boy, he could feel the flames that rushed towards him. He could feel them, you know, over, he could feel the heat over his forehead and his waving hair, okay, and looked from the lone post of death in still yet brave despair. Okay, so though he knew that the death was near, although the boy knew that his death, his end was near, because the ship caught fire, okay, and but he stood still, you know, quiet and calm. He was still very calm and very quiet. He was waiting for his father's permission to, you know, he was waiting for him to grant him the permission that he could leave his place and his duty was over. But children, as we all know, that his father was already dead, and so he was unaware of the, you know, situation of his son, where he was standing already. There was so much of panic all around him, but he looked around him from the place of death with, you know, with bold heart, though he knew that it was all very disappointing. He could not move from there because of his, you know, assigned duty, but still, you know, despite knowing that he would die, the child stood there on his duty, and you know, he stood there so bravely without having any hope. Children, despair means when we, you know, don't have any kind of hope, hopeless, that kind of situation. Okay, and shouted but once more aloud, "My father, must I stay?" While over him fast, through sail and shroud, the wreathing fires made way. Now again, once again, the boy shouted, he cried in a loud voice, and he wanted to know if it was necessary for him to stay there. And he was asking for the permission that, "Oh father, do I still need to be here?" And just then the flames, you know, rushed through the ropes and covered the sail, covered the boat. Now, as the boy was asking his father to be there or not to be there, the flames of the fire, they rushed towards the boy, and you know, they covered him, they wrapped him in, you know, in the whole fire. They wrapped the ship in splendor wild, they caught the flag on high, and streamed above the gallant child like banners in the sky. Now the, you know, ship was wrapped, you know, with all the fire and the, you know, or it was surrounded with fire, right, from all the sides it was covered with fire. Then the they even reached the flag, which was, you know, flying very high on that, on the pole, all right. And it streamed above the gallant child like banners in the sky. And then the, you know, the boy, the brave boy, he stood. Okay, so that boy, he, you know, standing there, and the flames of the fire, they surrounded him like anything, and it was, you know, like it all looked like, you know, the flags, the shadow, it was there in the sky. Alright, it all framed like that. The situation, the scenario was that bad. There came a burst of thunder. The boy, oh, where was he? Now, there was a sudden loud noise of, you know, thunder, and then no one can imagine where the body of the boy was gone, or of the brave boy had gone. Ask of the winds that far around with fragments strewed the sea. Okay, now it was only those winds who could, you know, who could say where the body of the boy was, you know, which the winds that were blowing all around, you know, yeah, all around the boy and everything all over the sea, and it, they were, the wind was scattered over the surface, and in that, you know, sudden loud noise of thunder and wind, I don't know, or nobody knows where the body of the boy was gone. With mast and helm and pennon fair, that well had borne their part. But the noblest thing which perished there was a young faithful heart. Okay, so children, now here the poet is saying that with mast and helm and pennon fair. Children, mast is, you know, kind of a tall pole, okay? And helm is called the, you know, steering of the ship. Pennon is called the, you know, the triangular flag, all right, that is always there on any ship. So it is saying that the part played by the, you know, that pole and the flag flying on it was praiseworthy, right? But the noblest thing that in the whole scenario was, what was the noblest thing in the whole scenario, that who died there was the young, obedient and a disciplined heart. It was a faithful heart. The boy was so faithful, so obedient, so disciplined he was, that, you know, he accepted his death. He could see his death, you know, near him, but still he stood like a brave boy over there, and he accepted it unless his father gave him the permission. But, you know, children, it was so sad that his father was already dead, and he could not, you know, grant his son the permission to leave that place, and his son also, you know, got dismissed in that ship, and nobody knew now where the body of the boy was led by the winds. Okay, so children, here we come to the end of the poem. I hope you all have understood. If you have not understood, please ask me either on WhatsApp or in the comment box. Thank you.